Hi there, in this video I'll take you through my journey of creating stunning cinematic artwork using Blender and Photoshop. Blender 3D is powerful open source 3D modeling and animation software that allows you to bring your imagination to life, but in this art I started with Photoshop instead of Blender because I need a sketch for my future art. I made this black and white sketch based on these two images which I generated using Midjourney. Why not? AI generated idea is not as good as the final result, final art, but it's pretty interesting concept that we may use as a base for digital art. I love this part of this concept, surrounding mountains and rocks looking interesting. So using these images I painted my concept in Photoshop and it must be a good one. I open Blender and let's take a look at what can be achieved with this idea. The main object here is the planet station, is some architectural construction. It's pretty easy to model just using simple circle mesh and I extrude other parts of the shape. Using the loop cut tool, I add edges and then extrude faces. Step by step I am creating a form, some kind of my sketch. By the way, you may notice that I am using my sketch in Blender. It's pretty easy to use any references, just drop your image into the image editor in a Blender, pin this one and your sketch will always be in front of you when you are walking. Using the same simple shapes I created the main architecture object in this scene. I spent a lot of time experimenting with how it should look, creating different shapes, extruding different parts of the building and trying to create some sci-fi architecture. For the first stage of the working process I need only a base form and details I'll make when I will have done the whole composition of my art and I will be sure it works well. Alright, let's create the surrounding mountains and other rock elements. For this I'm going to use sculpting tool in the Blender. I love Blender for this opportunity to work in one program and create everything inside one tool. Again, I use simple primitives, scale, duplicate and create a rough shape of the mountain, adding large and small parts. At this stage I want to make only base shape without details and after that I select all the parts and press Ctrl+J to combine them into one object. Go to sculpt mode and make remesh. It must be done because it will make a combined model with a large number of objects to solid surface suitable for sculpting. Using clay strips I continue making a base shape of the mountain, roughly sculpting large details. Don't be afraid about topology in this stage. First of all we need to create a base form of this rock and then in the next stage we can remesh and create a well looking topology. Now I can sculpt this mountain as I want, move and pull some parts of them forming a rock closer to my sketch and I think only about base form. When I deleted the mountain, I took scrub brush to finalize the mountain and just choose constant in falloff. Literally I used two brushes to sculpt rock in a Blender, clay and scrub brush, and it brings amazing result. Again, I don't care about topology at this stage because I will remesh before texturing and get a good topology of the mountain. Soil density topology is not good for texturing and we don't need to make a wrap from this high poly model. This is a common mistake that I see being made even by experienced artists. Guys, I would like to invite you to join my Patreon where you may find a lot of interesting and available for Patreon community scenes like high resolution of my arts with printable version, Blender scenes, materials, wallpapers, assets to community chat and Discord. Here I share my work in progress, you may see what I'm working on before it becomes public. Also, your subscription is your support for my channel. I will be very glad to see you in my Patreon community. Link in the description. So, when I created the whole objects in my scene, let's dive into the lighting. In this video, I will show you a way to create interesting light in a Blender using only sunlight and make fake shadows. Let's take another look in my sketch. I have deep shadows in the foreground, shadows here, and some shadows that fall off on this mountain. Add sunlight into the blender scene, adjust the angle closer to my sketch. And the question is how to make these deep shadows if in my scene I don't have any object behind the camera which can drop these shadows. The easiest way is to create simple object like cube, sphere and planes. Add a cube and place it some kind of like it may drop a shadow in the foreground area. I can duplicate this cube and make fake shadow in another part of my art. Add a sphere and drop the shadow to the mountain. I can combine different objects to create desirable result. Of course, we need a magic, and the magic is called volume scatter. I like what it looks like, especially this sun rays. I add one plane for the background with simple emission material. For now it's enough, but then I will place here image with planets as on my sketch. Don't be afraid to experiment with different combination to drop shadows as you need. Light is absolutely important tool in digital and traditional art. When you are creating art, you have to paint with light as a painter just using digital tools. Then your art will be picturesque and looks amazing. I talk a lot about light in almost every video. I tell my lighting workflow, but this video is mostly about my common workflow from start to finish in creating digital art. So, after modeling, sculpting, and when we create the base light system, it's time to move on the next stage, texturing. I want to show you my approach to texturing environment like rocks, mountains, and ground surface, and how we can create complex material inside the blender. I created rocks and mountains using sculpting tools, and now all the subjects have a huge density topology. For working with texture, we need to make a remesh and in some cases bake a normal map if we want to save all these details which sculpt before. Let's see how it works. I make remesh using the quad remesher add-on, then wait some time and get a low poly model. If I turn on my high poly model, see the difference. This model is ready for texturing, but I wanna bake a normal map from the high poly model and use this on my low poly model. Select the low poly model and unwrap using Smart UV Project. Next, we need a texture map for baking all details from the high poly model. Name it and increase the resolution. I don't need alpha. Important to use non-color in color space for normal map to bake everything properly. So I choose my high poly model and low poly model. Hold to render settings and use cycle render. I use a small value, samples and fine bake. We need a normal map. Selected to active, which means I want to bake from the high poly selected model to the low poly active model and press bake. After baking, I connect the normal map to the material. I make a copy of this object to show you how it looks on the render. This one is low poly model and this one is high poly model. And in the viewport we see the difference. But I turn on the render and now we can see all details from the high poly model on the low poly model, wherein the model has decent topology and on the render it looks similar. This way may help you not only work with texturing but save resources of your computer and video card as well. Remains only use some rocks texture and surrounding mountains ready to render. Go ahead, and now I want to make a texture for the ground. And I'm going to show you how to create a complex material in Blender. It's pretty similar to working in Substance Painter. If you're familiar with, you will understand what I'm talking about. So, I want to create a surface where the main material will be basic texture and the second material for the sand rods. Fortunately, Blender allows you to make it without any other tools. As I said, we need two materials. This one will be my main material which will cover all ground surface. And I add another one principle BSDF by pressing Ctrl Shift T. I can add texture and Blender connect each texture to the right socket on the material. If it doesn't work, you need to turn on an add-on, not random. Now we can see how this material works on the surface. So we have two materials for different parts of our surface, and we need to combine two different textures into one. Firstly, we need to add mix shader node and connect both of our materials. Next, we need a texture image node, which I will be using as a mask. Name a new texture as you wish. I use 4K size, it's pretty enough for mask image. As a base color, I leave a black color and connect it to the mix shader node. As you see, nothing happened, because we need to paint on this mask where I want to see the impression of the second material. But before, we need to repeat everything for displacement just using mix color node. For painting, go to texture painting mode, and now I can draw roads. If you create a black mask, use a white color to paint in the mask. Adjust the size of the brush to make a variety of roads. Some roads may be narrowed, some of them wider. If you struggle with what it might be looking for, just find references and try to transfer it to your art. Also, I turn on viewport shading to see how it looks in the render. Or use simple viewport in texture paint mode, you may see created black and white mask as well. Using this way, you may create absolutely amazing complex materials using a blender only, painting different textures and combine them into one material inside Blender. Just don't forget to save your mask, because Blender doesn't have it automatically. And if you forget, you may lose your process after some time, or when you close Blender, it also will disappear. So we created a nice complex material from two different materials, and I like how it looks like. In my sketch, I thought to depict some buggy riders who tried to achieve the station. So I need a 3D model for some wheels. One of the interesting websites where we can search for free 3D models is SketchFab, and one more useful thing is add-on for Blender, which can download any 3D model from SketchFab to your Blender scene, and you just need to copy the link of 3D model. Activate add-on and import from URL. Wait until the 3D model is downloaded, and here we are. I can add as many free 3D models as I need and everything directly into the Blender. I love Blender for this flexibility, when even a huge problem becomes a simple decision, and you can even search 3D models right here in the add-on inside Blender. Sometimes it has some problem with different object scales, so I use a new Blender scene to download 3D models, make a correct scale and copy these models to my main scene where I already can move them as I need in my scenario. Again, using my camera view, I see how it looks in my frame and adjust position as I want to see related to my sketch and compositions guidelines. Then I will draw or 3D render post effects like dust from wheels. But before I make a final render and go to Photoshop, I want to say a couple of words about the background planet in this art. As you may see, this scene is absolutely enormous in size, and if I would like to add a planet as a 3D model, it may stretch the scene to the endless scale. I don't do this, but instead, I'm going to use a simple images of the planet which I placed on the plane which I added when I had been working on the light system. I have a couple of nice unknown planets that I get from Envato Element. So in Photoshop I create an alpha channel for each image and slightly blur. It's necessary that in the render the border of the planet will not be so sharp and looks like it is a sphere that slightly disappear to the border of the shape. In the Blender, I just add this image into the material to base color and alpha, and of course to the emission. I also spent a lot of time experimenting with the main architecture object, creating different shapes, using different materials, and even using random flow add-on to add details and create more interesting. But finally I decided to use the materials that I used in this my project, because in this way it looks as I wanna see. So waiting for the render and going to Photoshop. Blender has 2D tools for creating, and here also we can draw, but it's not the same as Photoshop or Krita, where we can use different brushes or even create a custom brush and paint. Unfortunately, Blender is not Photoshop, and I guess if such tools appear in Blender, it would break my mind and industry apart at all. But now I will need Photoshop where I wanted to paint over my render. First, I'm going to draw details on the mountains to make it more rough and similar to rock. In Blender, I would be using displacement, but due to my scene being a large, displacement might take a lot of VRAM and render time might be a couple of times longer. Instead, I can draw all these details in Photoshop using an environment brush. Next, I'm doing some overpaint to make the line between the mountains and ground softer. Just paint this part to raise the sharp line and turn into natural. As I told you before, I am going to paint some dust from buggy. They are moving on the sand, and of course there must be dust from the wheels. So I am painting this part using fog and cloud brushes, which also fit this goal. To make it more picturesque, I am using the brush and erase tools to make it softer, reduce unnecessary part of dust and make it more realistic. Last but not least, I use camera roll to make color grading and adjustments and add some noise effects. This may help me to rid of digital effects from my concept. Also, using lens correction in Photoshop, I wanna add a distortion effect. Finally, I add rays from the light and emphasize and accent of the main part of my concept. I hope you enjoyed this journey into the world of creating cinematic concept art in Blender and Photoshop. Remember that the only limit in your creativity is your imagination. The tools like Blender and Photoshop are your paint brushes, and the canvas is the vast as your dreams. Don't be afraid to experiment and always keep learning. The world of digital art is constantly evolving with new techniques and plugins. Stay curious and embrace every opportunity to expand your skills. Creating cinematic concept art in Blender and Photoshop is not just a technical process. It's an artistical journey that allows you to breathe life into your wildest visions. Thank you for joining me today, and remember, the canvas is yours to create and the possibilities are endless. Keep creating, dreaming, and pushing the boundaries of creativity.